Julius here, and today, that's my kitty cat. Julius here, and today, we're gonna be going through the front side pop shove it, also known as front shoves. Let's get into it. So the prerequisites to this trick is the basic riding. You have to learn how to be comfortable riding on a skateboard. Secondly, you'll have to learn the ollie. When you have that down, start by placing your feet in an ollie position. At this point, you'd want to pop like an ollie with a slight difference. As soon as your tail comes in contact, you'd want to push down and out in front of you. Meanwhile, you want your front foot to completely sever connection from the board. You don't want to flick with your toe or flip with your heel. You want it to completely disconnect. So just move it out of the way. You will then notice the board rotating 180 degrees front side. And once you see the tail move up towards the front, have your front foot ready to catch the tail. Remember to always aim for the bolts. Once your front foot comes in contact with the tail, which is now the nose of the board, bring your back foot back and place it in the rear bolts. Then brace for impact, absorb with your knees, and ride away clean. Now, going through the challenges that I've personally had with this trick, every time I would start the rotation for the front shoves, it would boomerang away from me. At this point, I realized that I wasn't scraping hard enough. It almost feels like a tray flip, but if you've never tray flipped before, just think of it as like an ice cream scoop. So you'd be literally scooping your foot front side, forcing your tail and even the wheels to scrape and skid across the ground in front of you. The way I sort of think about it is if I were to jump backwards. Now with my mentality, every time I do this trick, I always focus on jumping backwards. If I were to jump backwards without focusing the scrape, I would just jump backwards and the board would just boomerang behind me. But if I also include the focus of scraping the tail along with the wheels, the rear wheels, then my body will not drift back and forward. Instead, the board will just actually rotate, completely eliminating that boomerang effect. Second, commitment. Always commit to your tricks. Better to commit to your tricks, let's just put it that way. Once you see that you're starting to make progress, take a little bit of a breather because it allows your brain and your body mechanics to store the information somehow. That way when you go to try it again, you'll be working with a rejuvenated mind and a more relaxed body. Making this one short and sweet. So if you like this video, please let me know by clicking that like button. If you have any thoughts, questions, or comments, please leave it down in the comment section below. And as always, thank you all so much for watching. My name is Julius, and if you haven't done so already, go and hit that subscribe button, as well as that notification bell for my future videos. And if you'd like to further contribute to this channel, go ahead and click that donate link on the bottom right-hand side of this banner. I'll see you all in the next one. Laters.